So guys, so today's topic for reference is parasitology. So if you have watched my previous videos, which has phycology, mycology and other stuff related to it, so it will be easy for you all to understand this video as well, which has the term named parasitology. So coming to the term of parasitology, so these are basically parasite, as the name suggests. So let's talk about some parasites, or what are its basic features and functions, and whether it's useful or harmful to our environment or society, okay? So, talking about parasites, these are organisms which are dependent on other organisms for survival, okay? So, basically, these are dependent on other organisms for their survival. Other organisms survival. Next is, these are eukaryotes, okay, as like fungi in my previous video, as I've told you. Next is, these are unicellular organisms, which counts in protozoa as well, which is a unicellular organism. Next, these can be multicellular as well, in organisms such as parasites, which one of the parasite I'll name as helminths, okay? So these are the some of the basic things, very basic things about parasites that you all need to know, okay? So let's define some of the terms related to parasites, okay? So what are parasites and basic things related to it, okay? So talking about parasites, these are host cells, these feed on host cells. So what is a host? Let's talk about a host. What is a host? It's an organism that provides nutrition to parasite, okay? Basically, parasite, as I told you, it feeds on host cells. So basically, it provides nutrition to parasites, okay? Next term is definitive host. What is definitive host, okay? So talking about definitive host, it's an adult stage of parasite which is locked and undergoes sexual reproduction both in males and females, okay? So this is an adult stage of host, okay? It undergoes sexual reproduction, as I told you. Both in males and females. Okay. The next term is intermediate host. So what is intermediate host? So talking about intermediate host, what is it basically? So intermediate hosts are harbors larval stage of helminths or asexual reproduction of protozoa. These are larval stage of helminths or asexual reproduction of protozoa. Okay, so these are the some of the terms that you all need to know, which is the host, definitive host and intermediate host related to parasites, okay, which is very important for you all to know. So talking about this parasitology, these also include organisms, as I told you. It contains protozoa, which counts under parasitology. So let's talk about protozoa now. Then let's talk about protozoa, okay? So what is protozoa? Basically, it is classified according to the organ of motility, okay? So classified on the basis of organ of Okay. Next is, it has pseudopodia like ammonia, amoeba. It's a false moving wall, just like in amoeba. It has cilia for locomotion. Cilia for cilia for prevention of dust particles to enter it. Next, it has flagellates for locomotion. Flagellar, flagellates. And the last part is sporozoa, which are non-motile. Spores or sporozoa, which are non-motile in nature. Okay, so this was protozoa and some of its basic features that you all need to know, okay, which is very important for you all. Okay, so let's talk about its basic, some of the terms related to protozoa and its classification according to the term given here, which is parasitology. So let's talk about some of the organisms related to it. Okay, so some of the organisms which are related to it are amoeba, okay, as I've already told you, it contains pseudopodia or a false wall for locomotion. Okay, there are some of the examples of amoeba such as E. histolytica, example such as histolytica. Okay, so the next organisms which is responsible for protozoa, which comes under protozoa, like amoeba, which has the false pseudopodia. Next are flagellates or flagella. It's naming some of the organisms such as Giardia. Okay, next is sporozoa, which has again which like contains an organism such as Plasmodium. Okay, and organisms such as ciliates, it has cilia, sporozoa, flagella, amoeba, all parts of protozoa, remember. Okay, so it has ciliates. Example of it is B. coli. Okay, so let's classify according to the site of infection. These terms are the site of infection. Okay, so classifying these terms on the site of infection, let's talk about them. So talking about its site of infection, it has infection such as parts such as intestine, in organisms such as E. histolytica. Next part, which is the genital tract, okay, in P. vaginalis. Pardon for the spelling. Okay, so next is blood, in organisms such as Plasmodium. Okay, so these are some of the site of infection that you all need to know, which is very important for you all to understand. So let's talk about the organism which is very important in this site of infection. Among these two are basic. Let's talk about histolytica. What is it basically, and a small glimpse of it. So let's talk about histolytica. Okay, so talking about Entamoeba histolytica, which is E. histolytica. Okay, so basically it depends on distribution, location. Okay, next, life cycle, disease caused. Okay, next is pathogenesis, removable or pathogenesis, and treatment. So these are some of the basic terms related to Entamoeba histolytica. So that's it from my video of parasitology. So keep following for more updates. Thank you.